The speed of a wave v is equal to lambda by t. Here simply two, the wave is traveling with a time t. After delta t time, the wave is traveling along this direction. Then this is the displacement of the two waves. Now y is equal to a sin kx minus omega t plus phi. In this, phi is equal to 0 because they are at the same phase angle. Then this kx minus omega t is always constant. For that, kx minus omega t we can write is equal to k into x plus delta x minus omega into t plus delta t. In the place of t, t plus delta t. Then we'll get delta x by delta t is equal to omega by k. Already we have k is equal to 2 pi by lambda. Omega is equal to 2 pi by t. If we substitute these values, then we get the speed of the wave v is equal to lambda by t. This is the speed of a wave. Now, the speed of a wave for the transverse wave in a stretched string. The speed of a wave, it is in a stretched string. That is also for the transverse wave I am taking. Here I am taking a string. Which has a mass m and a length l. Here this in this string the transverse wave is producing. The transverse wave is propagating. Then we have to find the speed of a wave. Already we know the wave. When a wave is traveling in a medium, then it depends on the elastic properties. And it depends on the inertial properties. Already wave propagating, when a wave is propagating, then it depends on the inertial properties and it depends on the elastic properties. Inertial properties means mass, density, like this. These are the inertial properties of a wave. Here, this string has very thin when comparing to the length of the string. Then we will take a linear mass density. Then this linear mass density we will take. Here, for that, for getting the speed of a wave by using we are using here dimensional formula. By using the dimensional formula, we'll get this speed of a wave in a stretched string. See here mu. This mu is the mass density. That is mass of a string is m, and then the mass per unit length. The mass per unit length is called mass density. And having the dimensional formula m l power minus 1. This is the dimensional formula for the mass density. And after that, we have a tension. When a string is stretched, then that tension produced in the string. That is, the tension produced in a string. T, this is a nothing but it is a force. Then we can write m l t power minus 2. This is the dimensional formula for the tension. Now here this tension by this density, that is a linear density, will give the speed. That means m l t power minus 2 by m l power minus 1. This gives the speed of a wave. That is a speed of a stretched string is equal to, we'll get this m cancel, we'll get l power minus 2 t power minus 2 will get l t power minus 2 will get, that is a m that is a l square will get a l square t power minus 2 will get, and speed is equal to v have l t power minus 1. This is called speed of a wave. Then by this already we have mass density mu and tension t we have. Now by substituting here we'll get the speed of a wave, the speed of a stretched string, then in a stretched string is equal to square root of t by mu we will get. Here if you take a constant c here, this is the dimensional constant c I am taking, and if this c is equal to 1, then we'll get the speed of a wave in a stretched string, that is t by mu, where t is the tension and mu is the mass density of the string. Then this is the relation for the speed of a wave in a stretched string. That is for the speed in a stretched string, v is equal to under root t by mu. And this speed is not depending on the frequency. It is not depending on the frequency. It depends only on the tension produced and the mass density. Now, the speed of a wave for the longitudinal wave. The speed of a longitudinal wave. Here for this longitudinal waves, the speed we are calculating. Now, the speed of a longitudinal wave, it travel in the form of compressions and rarefactions in the medium. Here, if we take a longitudinal wave, the compressions and wave fractions are produced. And for that, bulk modulus. The bulk modulus, B is equal to V have minus delta V by V. Here, this is the bulk modulus. And we'll get this bulk modulus because of when the particles of the medium, that means it produces the compressions and rarefactions, when the compressions are produced, then the density increases. And when the density increases, then the pressure, the change in the pressure also changing. That means here this pressure changes the force also, because this pressure is nothing but force per area. That means pressure is equal to force by area. Then if the pressure is changing, then this force also changing. These all depending on the bulk modulus. B is equal to minus delta P by delta V by V, because this volumetric. Here, when the compressions are rare fractions are produced, then we can get a volumetric strain. We'll get a volumetric strain in the medium. Then we can write the relevant equation, that is m l power minus 1 t power minus 2 by, we'll get for the density, m l power minus 3. This is the density and this is the tension in a stretched string. Then we'll get a l square t power minus t. We'll get. That means here already we have, this is a wave, this is the speed of a longitudinal wave. Then the speed of a longitudinal wave, v is equal to, we can write c into square root of this bulk modulus b by, this is the density of the wave, that is a rho. Then if we take this dimensional constant c is equal to 1, then we'll get the speed of a wave, that is a longitudinal wave, is a b by rho. V is equal to square root of b by rho. This b is the bulk modulus. Then here if you take a steel bar, then in this steel bar there are no volumetric expansions.